So I'm Mike Leminick.
And I'm Lee Billings.
And we're here to talk about dark matter. Just a few weeks ago, Vera Rubin, a very eminent astronomer, died. And many people think she should have gotten the Nobel Prize for her early measurements that suggested the existence of dark matter.
It's a grand picture that comes together, and every single piece of this puzzle says dark matter exists, it's real, it's about 85% of the universe.
Right.
Vera was looking at the rotation rates of galaxies, and she was noticing that essentially this thing was spinning around faster than it really should be able to hold itself together based on all the luminous stuff, the stars and things we see in it. So that suggests that there's something hidden, not luminous, dark, that is holding it together.
With gravity.
With gravity.
Right. When you look at clusters of galaxies, big collections of hundreds of galaxies that are kind of in a clump, they're orbiting around each other, and it's sort of the same thing. They're orbiting too fast, and if there's not some invisible matter whose gravity is holding it together, they should be flying out into the universe.
Right.
So there's another thing with clusters of galaxies. Einstein showed that big collections of mass can bend light from things beyond, like more distant galaxies. And we can see that lensing, but the amount of lensing we see comes from something much more massive than the galaxies that are visible. So there's some kind of matter there whose mass is bending light.
That's right.
And again, that's consistent with dark matter.
And so, we can also look back to the cosmic microwave background radiation, and we can see kind of an imprint. It's subtle, but an imprint within that radiation that suggests, hey, there is some kind of dark matter active even then.
So then the question is, what is it? And early on, I think there were two ideas.
Machos, of course, that's a massive, compact halo objects, which are supposed to be these big, dark things like planets, for instance, or even brown dwarfs, that float in the outskirts of galaxies. But the trouble is, you already mentioned Einstein's lensing and things. You know, we have these objects that can bend light. We look for lensing and shadows of those sorts of objects in the halo of the Milky Way and other galaxies, and we just don't see enough of them.
Right. So the search is really focused over the past 25 years or so on particles. Astronomers call them weakly interacting massive particles, WIMPs.
Right? Yep, yep.
Very cute. So we've been looking and and so far, nothing.
So far, nothing. Some tantalizing signals, but they all go away.
So then the question comes up, is it time to throw out the whole idea of dark matter? And people have suggested that what's really wrong is not that there are these particles out there we can't find, it's that we don't understand gravity well enough. There's a modification to Einstein's gravity that would explain some of these things.
Yeah, yeah, and I, you know, I think we have to admit that that's plausible, but is that the most plausible, the most parsimonious solution? I'm not sure if it is.
So if astronomers aren't yet ready to give up on Einstein's theory of gravity, why haven't we found these particles, if they're out there?
Well, it's tough to look for them. We don't quite know exactly how massive they are, exactly how they interact with ordinary matter. We're looking, you know, it's a needle in a haystack, where the haystack's the whole size of the universe, essentially. One analogy would be that we're trying to build a net, the net being the detectors that we can use to find these WIMPs. And so how big do you make the holes in your net to make sure that you're doing a thorough search?
I think that you got to make all sorts of different nets of different sizes, and that takes a while.
It takes a long time. Could take hundreds of years, in fact.
So if they don't find it next week, the theory is still good.
Yeah, the theory is still good. We should not throw out Einstein's understanding of the universe quite yet.
Okay. Dark matter.
There you go.